Hello, I'm Dr. Amar Chauhan, and today I will talk about EFAST. EFAST stands for Extended Focus Assessment Sonography in Trauma. Earlier, it was known as FAST because we were scanning only abdomen. Now the scanning has been extended to the chest, so that's why it is known as the EFAST. Now coming again to the probe selection, we will be using the convex probe, and for pleura, we can use linear probe. But for abnormal scan, we can use the convex probe. So coming to the position of the patient, obviously if we are doing this scanning in trauma, the patient will be in supine and the orientation marker will be towards the head of the patient. So first to identify the liver, like we will be performing four views. The first will be right upper quadrant view, the left upper quadrant view, the subcostal view and the pelvic view, and of course the e-scan will be scanning the chest as well. So coming to the first view, that is the right upper quadrant view. So we will first keep the probe between the ribs to identify liver. So you can see on the screen now, this is the liver, and if we scan a little bit down, then you can see that bean structure, that is the kidney. Yes, so if we label the structure, this is the liver and this is the bean shaped structure, right kidney, and the space between the liver and the right kidney is known as the Morrison pouch. And this is where the blood or the fluid get accumulated. So anything which is fluid will appear black on ultrasound. So you will see in case of hemuritanum, blackening of the space between the liver and the right kidney. So this is the first view, right upper quadrant view, for detecting fluid or the blood in case of hemoperitoneum. Now coming to the second view. The second will be left upper quadrant view. First again we will keep the probe between the ribs to localize the spleen. You can see that's the spleen on the screen. This is the spleen. And we will again focus the kidney. And this is the kidney. Again we will stop and label. This is spleen and this is left kidney. Again the blood will get accumulated between the spleen and the left kidney, and sometimes you have to keep your hand even on the bed also to have a better view, like me. And I will recommend that you better keep your hand on the bed when you are looking for blood between the spleen and the kidney, because it definitely gives a better view. As you can see now, you can see both the structure, this is the spleen and this is the kidney. Okay, now coming to the third view. The third view is the subcostal view. As I told you in the echocardiographic video, just keep the probe below the GP sternum, and of course the marker has to be on the right side of the shoulder, right shoulder. Now you can see on the screen, you can see the good contraction of the heart, and of course this is the liver, and this white structure is the pericardium. So in case of hemopericardium or cardiac tamponade, the fluid or the blood will get accumulated between the liver and the pericardium. Okay, we will label it. This is liver and this white structure is the pericardium, and this is the right atrium. I'll just make it more clear. Yes, so this white structure is the pericardium, and anything which is black in appearance in case of blunt trauma or penetrating trauma to the chest, you must suspect hemopericardium or cardiac tamponade. So this white, my idea is to show you the pericardium. So this white structure is the pericardium and this is the liver. Anything which is appearing black over the white structure will be blood in case of trauma and will be hemopericardium, and it sometimes can be cardiac tamponade. Okay. Now coming to the fourth view. The fourth will be the pelvic view. Just keep the probe just above the pubic symphysis, and what you see here, and push little bit toward the pubic symphysis. So you see on the screen, this is unibladder. As I told you, the fluid will appear black on ultrasound. So this is unibladder, which is quite well formed, and the black thing which we are seeing on the screen is the urine in the unibladder. So what will you see in case of bleeding in pelvic cavity in case of trauma? You will see blackening of the surrounding structure around the unibladder. You may see blackening over here or downward. So, but you memorize this clip, because this is unibladder, and because this is a well-formed structure, and the urine is contained inside the unibladder. So this was the fourth view. So now coming to the chest view. So first we will again focus the diaphragm, and we will keep the probe between the anterior axillary line and posterior axillary line. And what we see here, now please focus on the screen. This white structure is the diaphragm, and this is the liver. If we freeze it, liver, this is the diaphragm and this is the liver. So the fluid will get accumulated between the diaphragm and the liver in case of hemothorax. Okay, so similarly you can scan on the left side. Now to visualize the pleura in case of pneumothorax, I think it's better to use the linear probe. So we are using the linear probe, and we will move slightly upward. And of course you will have to reduce the depth. Now as you can see, this white shimmering structure which is moving with the respiration is the pleura. So the movement of the pleura with the respiration is known as the lung sliding, and this will be absent in case of pneumothorax because the air will restrict the movement of the pleura. So this is how you scan the chest also, because the pneumothorax and the hemothorax, they are potentially life-threatening condition, and you should be able to scan the abdomen and the chest in case of trauma to chest or abdomen, either penetrating or blunt. And I think by now you have realized that how important is to do EFAST in case of especially in case of hemodynamically unstable patient, to know where is the source of bleed. And we are holding workshop, that is work EM1 workshop, where we are teaching direct laryngoscopy, video laryngoscopy, difficult intubation, surgical cryc, central line insertion, and chest tube needle decompression, basic ECHO, blue protocol, and of course the EFAST. So these are the skills which you must acquire in case if you are working in an emergency, and definitely if you have these skills, you will be able to resuscitate the patient in a better manner, and definitely you will be able to save a lot more lives. And thanks for watching video, and thanks Prince for being a volunteer. Thank you very much.